All right, today is a more lighthearted video where we simply look at the absurdity of a situation where a single tweet from a notably controversial crypto publication caused this to happen. This being a temporary spike in the Bitcoin price, which liquidated short positions and then came crashing back down to earth because it was entirely fake. How, you might ask? How does something like that even happen? Well, that's what we're here to discuss. To understand fully, we need to begin with the guilty party, who seems to be doing a quick little 3-hour investigation, or so they say, before getting back to business as usual. Well, it's been 3 hours, they continue to post articles and operate like nothing happened in the interim, and still nothing. Maybe they end up saying something about it later on, maybe not, but a $100 million market manipulation event isn't exactly going to just disappear. So yeah, they can act like nothing happened, but something certainly happened. Cointelegraph paints itself as a sort of industry watchdog. They want to find things that people don't know and tell them about it. On the surface, that's probably good journalism, one might think, but when you look deeper at who they are and what the business actually is, things change. I'll start with firsthand testimony from an ex-writer named Ian DeMartino, who seemed to do the majority of his work there in 2015. His retelling of events that transpired at the outlet is rather scathing, but I'll simplify it down to a couple of key items. One, the outlet did not seem to care at all about plagiarism. He reported it multiple times, and the response was to effectively try and sidestep the issue, which was indeed a problem. I did a little text comparison here, if you will, and yes, he's right. Certain articles by a particular writer still, to this very day, 8 years later, contain line-by-line plagiarism from elsewhere in the industry. Bad sign? Yes, but all-encompassing? No, not exactly. The real problem comes when he gives his account of paid promos and alleges that the outlet had a lengthy list of clients engaging them for that purpose. Quote, "It hardly ended there, and they made it very clear to me that while they favored all of the crypto note coins outside of Monero, Bitcoin was their clear favorite and was pumped from nearly the beginning. Early on, that was the only subject they asked that I cover in a promo fashion, but that client list soon grew. Initially, paid posts were supposed to stay under a business catalog we were creating. There are hardly any business catalog posts on Cointelegraph anymore, and I have my doubts that promo pieces are still confined to that section." End quote. Those are the words of a former writer many years ago, but they paint a picture of pay-for-play type coverage that has plagued the crypto industry since the very beginning. Not a good start. However, that was then and this is now, so what could possibly set the stage for a simple tweet to do $100 million worth of market manipulation? The answer to that question is best described as the industry frothing at the mouth for institutional investments. Here's the gist of it. Bitcoin ETFs have existed for years, but the iterations out there right now are built on derivatives. There is no actual Bitcoin ETF trading in the United States at the moment that holds Bitcoin itself, and this particular type, called a spot Bitcoin ETF, is expected to usher in a tidal wave of new institutional interest, if or when it gets approved. There have been several attempts made over the years, but the one that everyone is currently focused on is the iShares Bitcoin ETF application from BlackRock, which the SEC has formally accepted for review. It's funny, at least to me, because BlackRock CEO Larry Fink previously referred to Bitcoin as an index of money laundering, but regardless, there is a proposal on the table by BlackRock which is expected to have a monumental impact if accepted. That's why the dominoes were lined up so perfectly for all this. So what happened? Well, discovered by Zach XBT, I'll link his Twitter down below, he does incredible work in the crypto industry, somewhere in the recesses of Telegram, some chat in the back alleys of the platform, a user named Deadlier posted, quote, "Breaking, SEC approves iShares Bitcoin Spot ETF, BBG," end quote. Funnily enough, the link above that post is research from Guardio, one of this channel's sponsors, where they found new evidence of malicious code in smart contracts. They have a threat prevention extension for the Chrome browser. They do great work. Of course, they're a sponsor again. And there's a link down below for anyone who wants to check them out. Anyway, this random internet user, Deadlier, posts in a Telegram chat saying that the SEC approves BlackRock's application. And then 39 minutes later, to be precise, Cointelegraph just YOLO tweets it out to the world as if it's true. After that, some very large accounts like Gergavin picked it up on the platform, and the effects became obvious. Based on nothing but a random Telegram message, hundreds of millions of dollars started panic buying into Bitcoin, causing a multi-$1,000 spike in less than 12 minutes. And then, almost as fast as it happened going up, it came crashing back down. Fox News journalist Eleanor Terrett announced that BlackRock had confirmed to her the rumor was entirely false, and the price immediately started to tank. But it didn't stop there. Instead of deleting the post, no, Cointelegraph edited the tweet to say reportedly at the end, before finally deleting it after that, demonstrating that the outlet will just take, I can't believe this is standard crypto journalism, Cointelegraph will take random comments from a Telegram room and tweet them out, ultimately impacting the entire industry and manipulating hundreds of millions of dollars worth of capital. What an absolute clown show. Funnily enough, this is one of the precise issues that the SEC has addressed before when denying similar applications, and probably the same primary reasons why there has not yet been a spot ETF created thus far. The SEC identified seven different things: wash trading, persons with a dominant position in Bitcoin manipulating Bitcoin pricing, hacking of the Bitcoin network and trading platforms, malicious control of the Bitcoin network, trading based on material non-public information, manipulating activity involving purported stablecoins, including Tether, and fraud and manipulation at Bitcoin trading platforms. These are hilarious to me because pretty much every single one is not only quite obviously still true, but Cointelegraph publishing a confirmation of the spot ETF approval based on nothing other than a random Telegram message, thereby impacting hundreds of millions of dollars and causing a double-digit percentage spike in a matter of minutes. I mean, you couldn't possibly have a more flagrant example of manipulation than that. These problems are actually integral to the industry. Wash trading is an omnipresent phenomenon, and centralized exchanges are rife with it. Dominant positions in Bitcoin being able to manipulate the price has always been true. Hacking of the network and trading platforms, Bitfinex, Mt. Gox, two of the largest centralized platforms in their day, both hacked. And that makes no mention of the billions in other crypto hacks that weren't Bitcoin specific. It's not just growing pains, it's an industry built on crime. 51% attacks are a real thing, so malicious control of the Bitcoin network is definitely still a concern, and so is trading on material non-public information. Effectively, the mere fact that Cointelegraph can just post a random tweet from nothing other than an anonymous Telegram banter session and then impact hundreds of millions of dollars in capital is proof in and of itself that a spot ETF is still very much out of the question. Now, I can say that and I can have an opinion on that, but it doesn't mean it won't get approved. One of the reasons everyone is foaming at the mouth over BlackRock's individual application is that they have a 575-1 track record of getting ETF applications approved by the SEC. That's an unbelievable win percentage for them, making this a completely different creature, and also signaling that they had a legitimate reason to do this in the first place, this about face really, and suddenly file one. They don't do haphazard applications, that's obvious. So I'm not saying it's impossible that we see approval. I'm saying it's utterly hilarious that a rumor of that approval has now caused hundreds of millions of dollars in market manipulation, when one of the concerns holding approval back is market manipulation. Actually, now that I think about it as I scroll their social feed, it looks to me like Cointelegraph went back and added a bunch of new comments under prior stories, which served as a way to bury the "we're doing an investigation" tweet further down when you go to their profile. It's actually smart. It is. Those stories now pop up first, despite being 9 or 10 or 13 hours old, and the comment is what was posted more recently, which gives them a buffer zone. They seem to be running and hiding from this mess rather than actually taking ownership and coming clean. That someone over there massively influenced the price based on absolutely nothing. Funnily enough, one user posted what seems to be an individual slide from some kind of Cointelegraph presentation or media kit below their investigation, which showcases that you can buy access to their Twitter. This line in particular: crafted text reflecting your unique voice, to be specific. But I couldn't find anything about that on the actual website, making it even more hilarious and confusing as to how all of this happened in the first place. People say I'm overzealous with my hatred of crypto, and that's probably true, I'll give you that. But when things like this are happening, how can anyone treat the industry as credible? If a random guy on Telegram in a chat room can cause main stage industry publications to post fake headlines and then domino into a $2,000 price increase in 12 minutes for literally no reason, how in the world is someone supposed to look at that and say, yeah, that's definitely the future of finance? I understand that there are flaws in any financial system, but this seems like a lot more than just a flaw. This, in my opinion, looks like the psychology of 10 million I want to be rich so bad I lost my grasp on basic sanity bros, some of them worth quite a lot of money, congregating in online forums, just throwing handfuls of cash at whatever they see, and that level of desperation gives rise to things like this. That is to say, ridiculous things that make no sense. I do admit and understand as well that there are some incredibly intelligent people doing incredibly intelligent things with the underlying concept of blockchain, but its position as a financial vehicle on an industry-wide level is wildly unstable. It always has been, and if events like this are to serve as any indication, it always will be, because the entire foundation is, I want to be rich, magnified tenfold by desperation and leverage. That's true in traditional finance as well, but at least you have the added factor of actual assets, physical things, real estate, underlying companies that provide services, products, goods, and value, stabilizing things like the pontoons on a seaplane, I guess. Crypto is not the pontoons on a seaplane, it's a canoe with a jet engine duct taped to it. Yeah, it might get airborne for a little bit, but it's also on a completely unstable trajectory where a literal gust of wind can send it tanking into the waves like a missile. Fun to watch, maybe even fun to ride, but extremely dangerous. Anyway, that's it. As of the making of this video, Cointelegraph is well past their 3-hour investigation target where they'd say what had happened after single-handedly causing a panic flow where hundreds of millions of dollars got thrown at something for legitimately no valid reason. I can only imagine what they might eventually say, but in a sense, crypto is wonderful because crypto is the only industry where a journalistic publication with anonymous owners can impulsively turn a Telegram rumor, one message on the platform, into a tweet and lose people hundreds of millions. That's it. If you want support, check out the links down below. Guardio to help protect Chrome users if you want. Surfshark for anyone who wants a sweet deal on a VPN with a massive discount. Everybody could use that. And more. Locals, Patreon, membership, etc. But I'll cut it there and stop rambling. As always, thank you all for watching and have a nice night.